Hello there and welcome to this week's business interview. My name is Violet Sasira and we are joined by Ali Twaha, who is a business journalist and editor with The New Vision. Hello Ali, and thank you so much for making time to be part of this interview. So let's dive in, right, starting with the budget. So Parliament approved a proposed budget draft of 49.9 trillion shillings. And so I'm asking you to highlight for Ugandans what stood out and what a common man needs to know about this budget.
Thank you for having me, Viola. And a quick look through about the big stories that we had in the week was about the budget from Parliament. And Parliament approved the draft national budget, which amounts to about 50 trillion shillings. Now, that the 50 trillion shilling represents about 1.8 trillion if you compare that to the running budget that we have now, which was about 48 trillion. Now, government is focusing to collect only of the 50 trillion, domestic taxes will be only 28 trillion. So someone will wonder, where will the rest of the money come from? So government will be looking to borrow internally, but also externally to finance the budget. Now, of the 50 trillion, you can only finance 28 trillion. That means you're biting more than you can chew. So that's the dilemma we find ourselves into as a country. But the funds will come through.
So government is looking to collect 28 trillion shillings as part of the 50 trillion budget from domestic revenue. And so Ugandans are always, you know, wondering why they're collecting more and more taxes and where these taxes are going. So talk to us about collecting 28 trillion shillings from Ugandans and what that will mean for a person, for example, owning a business, and where will the rest of the money come from?
So government will be looking to borrow this money domestically. And we've seen when that happens, interest rates tend to go high. You know, government borrows through the market, through the treasury bills and treasury bonds. And I think you've been seeing some of those auctions that Bank of Uganda carries out. So Bank of Uganda is the, you know, mobilizes money for government through treasury bills and treasury bonds. Now, we, over the years, what we have seen is that the biggest share of the budget, of course, goes to security and debt repayment. But on the issue of the debt, yes, we've somehow reached the 50% GDP threshold, but government says it is still sustainable, so yes, we can go with the flow.
So speaking about your, the president mentioned at his, you know, Emmanuel Mutebile memorial lecture, he said that a lot of money is lost within the process, you know, from URA to the Ministry of Finance. He says there is a lot of corruption in the Ministry of Finance. And so how can we encourage Ugandans to collect more tax, you know, be positive about collecting taxes when actually the money is not getting to where it's supposed to be, but we see the budget increasing every year and more collection has to come from within us?
For half year, they had a target of 11.7 trillion. But they were able to collect only 11.6 trillion. That's the half year looking at July up to December. So those are the results they shared with us. Now, at the memorial lecture of the late Mutebile, Museveni said that the taxes are there, but it seems the system is the one failing, you know, the taxes he wants to collect. But also, if I can pick a few points from the guest speaker, who is the director, African Department at IMF, Mr. Abe Beselassie. He said that he has been coming to this country for 20 years, and along Entebbe Road, he has seen a lot of things change just on the road. That means government has done a lot by investing in the infrastructure, but it has not been able to recoup some of the gains through, you know, through taxation, because real estate is one of those areas where people hide their wealth, and we know that it's not paying its fair share of taxes.
All right. So also about investment, President Museveni mentioned the fact that they are thinking about, as government, they're thinking about reducing some of the tax exemptions given to especially investors in order to be able to collect as much money as possible locally. So what are your comments about reducing tax exemptions? Is this a good route for us to take as a country? Do we see ourselves losing investment, or is it actually okay in order to get more domestic collection?
What I know of is that government is relooking into some of these exemptions that they've given to investors, because there have been calls from civil society organizations that they want these companies to actually show what they are doing. If it's jobs, if a company comes and it says it's going to create 10,000 jobs in, let's say, 5-10 years, has it done those? You know, kind of weighing the benefits of, you know, giving someone tax exemptions for 10 years, but what has it done? So those are some of the discussions that are going on at finance. And the other thing is that there is a whole, government is re-looking into the whole Income Tax Act, you know. They are trying, you know, to, most businesses are moving online. So they want to re-look into some of those policies and make sure that even companies online pay their fair share of taxes. Yes.
All right. Thank you very much for making time to be part of this interview this week, and we hope to hear from you soon. And to you, thank you very much for also being a part of this interview. It's always because of you that we do this every week to make sure you have the latest happening in the world of business. We shall see you next week. I am Violet Sassera. Back to the news.